fun, it's entertaining. It takes a lot of time, but it's worth it in the end. It's fun to put it on. It's fun backstage, even though we're still talking and whatsoever.
We get our confused.
Yeah.
Now you guys know.
It's fun.
It's been a lot of really hard work, and then there's been a lot of really fun times, which is a total blast. I know everybody has put their heart into it, especially all the teachers writing scripts and songs to match what we need. It's just been a blast. I know everybody's got a new personality themselves, and they didn't know that they had. And now, we hope you enjoy the show.
Yeah. that is what the Bible tells us.
She has just lost my attention.
Yeah, we're out of here.
Hear me, gamblers, with your cards or dice and your horses.
Never mind them, Sarah, go on.
Sarah, go on.
Just around the corner is our little mission for your always welcome sea grasses from this jungle of sin. Join me, brothers and sisters, in resisting the devil, and we can put the devil. Remember, friends, the Fableful Mission is located at 409 West 49th Street, open all day and night. Well, we might as well pack up.
Cheer up, Sarah. Did you notice that this time they said you were almost done? Next time they may stay until the end. You'll have to full attention one day.
Well, I was a betting person, and I'm not. I wouldn't have very good odds on that happening.
That works the mysterious ways right here. Put your trust in him.
Thank you.
deeply touched by your loyalty. Do not worry. Dame Detroit does here will pull again.
Hey Nathan, guess who's in town looking for some action? None other than Sky Masterson.
Sky Masterson? I have player of them all. What a spot I'm in.
Maybe you can borrow $1,000 from Sky.
Not Sky. With him, that kind of money ain't lending money. It's betting money. So why don't I just bet $1,000 on Sky?
You would bet the Sky Masterson?
Sure. I ain't scared. I'm perfectly willing to take the risk. Providing I can figure out something, what's your no chance of losing? He likes those crazy bets. Well, I once saw him bet 5 G's on which raindrop would reach the bottom of the window pane first. I got it. Go on to Mindy's and ask Mindy how many pieces of cheesecake he sold yesterday, and also how much strudel.
How many pieces of cheesecake? How much strudel? What do you want to know that for?
Just that. Now beat it. Here comes Abner. If she hears him run the dice game, she never says, put on me a guy.
Yep, 14 years. Nice friends you are. You know how I feel about my Nathan. It's not his fault he's got so many obligations that we ain't been able to afford to get married yet.
Obligations? Like the dice game?
He promised he gave it all up. Hello, Nathan, dear.
Hello, Emily, Bridget.
You go ahead, girls. Order me a 2-9-1 and chocolate sundae.
Hey, Ellie.
Hello, on the bad Nathan.
You gotta get back to the hot box.
Zoomtag, your cold's not seeming to get any better.
It comes and goes. It's just a chronic condition. And speaking of chronic conditions, get me in a way to you. Go ahead, open it.
What is it? $1,000?
I wish.
Dave Detroit, general manager. General manager of what?
Whatever you want, Nathan. You can be whatever you set your mind to.
I regret to say that I didn't actually give you your present.
Oh, that's all right, Nathan. Time to make me feel like you was already married.
Don't you worry, honey.
One of these days, I'll be in the money, and you'll have more bank than a bank.
Nathan, I don't know about anything. Just so long as you don't run that dice game again.
The dice game? What an absurd thought.
Let me take that for you. We gotta go, Nathan. That's why the slave driver at the hot box. Come on, girl. Bye, Nathan.
Bye.
Yesterday, Mimi sold 1,200 cheesecake and 1,500 shoes.
That's great. More shoes than cheesecake. Here comes Scott. I'll talk to you later, right?
Nathan, don't come over to you.
All right, Sky. Gonna be in town long?
No, I'll find you a banner tomorrow.
A banner?
Yeah, there's lashing down there. Wanna come with me?
No, I can't. I got a lot of things to do down here. No, you hungry? I was thinking maybe we go over to Mindy's and grab a piece of cheesecake or stew or something.
Well, I think I'll go with late racing bolts.
Will you agree with me when I say that Mindy has the greatest cheesecake in the country?
Yes, I'm quite partial to Mindy's cheesecake.
Well, wait. But then there are some for his stew or his cheesecake. Tell me, offhand, which do you think Mindy sells more, his cheesecake or his stew?
Well, I've never given much thought, but if everybody's like I am, I'd say he sells much more cheesecake than strudel.
For how much?
Huh?
I'm willing to bet you $1,000 that yesterday he sold more cheesecake than he did strudel.
Nathan, let me tell you a little story.
Aw.
When I was a young man, best girls in this world, my father says to me a very valuable thing. Son, my daddy says, one day he travels, the guy's going to come to you with a brand new deck of cards and offer to make the jackass patient out of the deck for size and hair. But son, as sure as you are, you don't bet this man, you don't wind up with a beautiful Saturday. Now, Nathan, I do not claim that you pocket me cheesecake.
But I do such a thing.
However, if you're really looking for some action, I'm going to bet you the same $1,000 you do not lift up your necktie. Well?
Oh, bad. Polka dots. What a crazy color.
Hey, Nathan, you just ran into Adelaide at the grocery store.
Yeah, she said not to forget to pick her up at the hot box after the show.
Yes, dear. I mean,
yes, dear, but that is how to talk about her hurting. Nathan, you're trapped. Adelaide, you're the kind of girl that's all difficult to unload.
I don't want to unload. I love Adelaide. And the guy with that doll? Well, doll's a necessity.
Nathan, I'm not putting rap on dolls. I'm just screaming weight for age. All dolls are the same.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
And not when you ain't got a doll. Not when you're flying a man alone tomorrow without one.
Well, I can check a light. But those chicken dolls are better for me. There's a large sort available.
Not real life glass now.
Any doll. You
can. Any doll. And I can. Are you on the back of that? It'll be $1,000 for riding any doll.
I am her.
Say no more.
Say no more.
Say no more.
my ears.
My heart. He'll know, and he won't stand alone.
lot of books, Lizzie. Maybe you become a regular book.
It's very interesting. Trust me, I want to see him about my cold.
How is your cold?
It's the thing. The doctor asked me how long he had it, and I told him a long time. So he said to read this book, because it might be using her like cold.
I got that too, do you?
Nathan, this is just like poetry that tells us what goes to certain kinds of things. What do you think I got in this box?
Sally's budget show. I can't guess.
It's a wedding deal, and I can't for 3 years, but I'm not going to show it to you because it's bad luck. Would you like to see it?
It's bad luck.
Do you see, Nathan, darling? I got the deal. All we know is a license and a blood test.
A what?
Blood test is the law.
What is it? First, they close up my Thanksgiving, and they open up my vein.
Nathan, you promised me you'd give that all up. You're not playing to run your dice game again.
Evelyn, why do you think such a thing? Why do you think I gave up the dice game? It's because I love you, and I want us to get married. You're the happiest married couple that there is in the world.
Hey, Adelaide, I just came, girl. You! I'm all faded of tomorrow's society match, and he brings it on account of your dopey dice game. Honestly, Adelaide, I pity you.
Evelyn, look at you. Mom, I need
you. Oh, get up. Remind me about these dice games.
Well, you're getting yourself all upset. Don't worry. You're not going to be all right. After all, we love each other. We're going to get married.
I don't believe you anymore.
You'll feel better tomorrow. Come on. Cheer up. Let's see that old smile. Hey, girl. I'll see you tomorrow.
The average unmarried female, basically insecure.
Thank you.
don't take it to Havana.
Well, man, I think I'm Dave the Stout and Will
Where's Dave? We all just lined up to you.
We don't know. I suppose he's trying to see Miss Adelaide. She's mad at him. Again.
Yeah, that Adelaide is always taking his mind off honest work.
Jenny, that's his weakness, and we should be telling him. Because I don't know what this world's like.
Hallelujah!
take it easy, Harry.
I would like to meet Big Julie from Chicago.
So this is Big Julie.
Yeah.
How do you do, Big Julie?
I come here to shoot dice. Let's shoot dice.
Big Julie, believe what I taught you, that when Abe Detroit raises something, you can count on it, Dad.
Well, 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 interesting gathering. Figuring with society. Angie the Act, Society Max, Rusty Charlie, Liberalist Julie, Mini Boots. And that one, I don't know. What's the occasion, gentlemen?
Wow.
It's a party.
Indeed, what kind of a party?
It's like you'll see tomorrow.
It's a bedroom dinner. Kids get married.
What?
It's a bachelor. Kids get married.
Yes, sir.
For he's a jolly fellow. He's a jolly fellow. He's a jolly fellow.
Which nobody cannot deny.
Nathan, God, I'm so thrilled. Why didn't you tell me?
Because it was a surprise. Oh, it's a bachelor dinner. Yes, sir, it's a bachelor dinner.
Just think, after 14 years, I'm finally going to be Mrs. Nathan Detroit. Time certainly does fly.
Tell me, Nathan, when is the happy day?
Yes, I'll make a note of it.
When will it be, Nathan?
Wow.
Nathan, these good fellows are nice enough to throw you a bachelor dinner. Please tell them the wedding day.
Well, we need time. For a license.
You could elope.
What?
You can drive down to Maryland. You don't even need... You don't
need
to need the blood test.
Ain't that unhealthy?
Oh,
what the heck?
I congratulate you too, Nathan. I can only hope there's nothing too ready,
yeah. Oh, Nathan, I got so many things to do before we elope. You'll be at the hot box tomorrow night.
Yeah, I'll have a table reserved, and I'll be all dressed up in whatever we elope in.
Oh, Nathan, I'm so happy. Nathan, you are indeed a local fellow. The most beautiful gal in the East. You agree with Julie?
Let's shoot dice.
Nathan, you gotta find a place for the game.
Okay, but this guy ain't come in yet.
Maybe he won't come. Maybe he took the dog in the
van. He could. Oh, good.
Right.
Sarah, I think you better sit down. This is a predicament. Do you feel all right?
Am I all right? Never been brighter. Ask me how do I feel? Ask me now that I hear my heart speaking. Well, sir, all I can say is if I were a bell, maybe a ringing. From the moment we met tonight, then the way I just got to behave. Boy, if I was a lamp, I'd light.
Thank you.
Brown?
Explain what?
Oh, I see. It's just one big coincidence. This permission was left open and empty all night.
And everybody went out on an all-night crusade. That is except you, and you weren't here.
Well, that's one coincidence too many. And you, Sky Masterson, I thought you were at least a high-class handler, not just some happy for Detroit to pull these ice cubes.
And boy, you guys came going to Kovac's admission, no less.
Dice game?
Sarah, you don't really believe I had anything to do with this, do you?
This never would have happened if I hadn't gone with you in the first place.
You don't like me to help commission?
Some help. It seems all I did was help you use commission for gambling.
You can't believe that.
Can't I?
You guys all you anyway.
A mission job. Come on, Irina, lady.
Sarah, you don't really think he has anything to do with all that, do you? He does seem to care for you, and you for him.
I can never care for a gambler.
Evening, Sister Sarah. Sister Arvina. Supposed to be soul saving. That's a big meeting, isn't it?
It's supposed to be. The general is coming.
Come on, Arvina. We've got to hurry.
Miss Sarah, yes, you took Godzilla. But even with gambling, never forget things like this. Take home a mark for Paul Sitters.
Mr. Masterson, Anna said the mission was filled with your friends. Let's just say we're here.
If you don't make good on that marker, I'll tell the whole town you're a welcher.
Chance, I can come up with the hard one.
Ha!
Say, who is this guy?
The guy I was telling you about. He took the mission down from a van off.
Look, fella, you're sawing up the action around here.
If you're looking for some action, would you care if it's a small wager and a proposition?
What's the proposition?
By writing your luck, Jamie.
How would I know a thing like that?
I'll give you a clue.
Calendar turn, let's see your throw up.
Look, you guys, I missed Sarah's mission, told you, holding a midnight prayer meeting. I promised them that I'd build them some sitters. And you guys certainly feel that, too.
I don't want to go to Hallelujah tonight.
I guarantee you that the air there is sooner cleaner than down here. Well, I'll try. See you, Nathan.
Oh, Scott, about that van business. I got to say that I don't have a chance to know you to pay for the door right now.
Sorry, Nathan, you have to pay me.
I thought you took the Sarah to van with you.
Oh, huh.
Come on, Big Julie, get up. I know if the door roll is my business.
Big Dan does? Big Julie can't ask to save his soul.
What did you say?
Okay, Adelaide, but I can't right now.
Adelaide,
because, well, I got to go to a prayer meeting.
This is the biggest lie you ever told me.
I promise you, it's true.
Someone save me! Has someone
before in my life.
Now there's a right frog.
My name's Bill Bradigan.
Thank you, Miss Sarah. People, I have a confession thing. I got to get it off my chest. We did shoot dice here last night, and we're sorry. Hey, big boy.
Yeah.
I didn't know a terrible thing. I made a vow to a certain guy that he could not take a certain dollar away from my trip. This I should not have done. Although it's not doing harm, as I was left.
You won the bet?
Sure. The guy said he didn't take the dollar from the van. That makes me feel a lot better.
Hallelujah.
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 Marry the man today. Presents life and music.
Thank you for coming. We know it's a long time to sit, but we got to go to school for an hour and a half. And we hope you enjoyed it.